Hey, what's up guys? Mikey here. Lately, I've been spending money on new video games as they come out. I'm always looking forward to playing the hip new Nintendo game that's being hyped up. However, I have been pretty broke lately, but I guess that's the price to pay for keeping up with the world as it is.
Bossy Boots is the episode where Pearl works at the Krusty Krab during her summer vacation and turns it into a place for teenagers to hang out, but at a certain cost. Like Something Smells, this episode aired on October 26, 2000, and is that episode where Pearl kisses SpongeBob.
Damn. And to think the show staff said that SpongeBob has no sexual orientation.
Something else I didn't realize until recently is that this episode is the only episode of Season 2 where Pearl has a major appearance. Obviously, she appears in more episodes of Season 2 than just this, but this is the only episode where she has a lead role with a lot of screen time. Similar to episode 24, The Chaperone. Also, since this and its sister episode, episode 44, Something Smells, are the first season 2 episodes to air, the second half of what I call this production episode is focused on SpongeBob and Pearl. The final single episode of the first production episode of season 1 is on SpongeBob and Sandy. For those that like shipping characters and nothing else in life, some fans think that Sandy and Pearl could be rival love interests for SpongeBob, which feels kind of appropriate that the final single episode of the first half hour of season 2 to air focuses on the second major girl character people talk about alongside SpongeBob himself, and the final single episode of the first half hour of season 1, which is episode 3, Tia the Trito, is focused on the first major girl character that people talk about with SpongeBob. But of course, that's a total coincidence and very irrelevant. This episode also features the Capsules as a special musical guest. I always saw it in the opening credits, but I had no idea where their part was in the episode. But only recently, I learned their musical appearance was the music that played in the background during the first scene inside the Kuddly Krab. And I think that's pretty neat. So let's take a look at this episode and check out the good old Kuddly Krab. So the episode starts up, and Mr. Krabs calls SpongeBob and Squidward into his office with a wireless megaphone.
You don't need a megaphone if you're 3 feet away from them.
In his office, Mr. Krabs told SpongeBob and Squidward about how his daughter Pearl would be working at the Krusty Krab during her summer vacation. When Pearl arrives, Mr. Krabs left the office, and Squidward talked to SpongeBob because he wasn't pleased about a teenager telling them what to do, so they decided to protect their jobs. Mr. Krabs then introduced them to Pearl.
They've already seen Pearl before.
Mr. Krabs was pleased to have Pearl working at the Krusty Krab and then went into his office. Pearl showed the new Krusty Krab uniform that she designed herself. Squidward told SpongeBob to tell Pearl how he really felt about the uniform, and of course, SpongeBob liked it. Squidward wasn't happy, and when Pearl tried to give him a uniform, Squidward didn't want it, saying fools would wear it, and Mr. Krabs was wearing it too.
Well, to be fair, Squidward thinks everybody's a fool except for him.
Mr. Krabs still made Squidward put on the uniform, and Squidward was furious having to wear it. Pearl started talking to SpongeBob, saying that she had some ideas to transform the Krusty Krab into a cooler place for the people of Bikini Bottom, more specifically teenagers, and SpongeBob agreed. Later, while SpongeBob and Pearl were trying to brainstorm new ideas, Squidward tried to intervene, saying the Krusty Krab's name may be bad, but the place itself is also bad, so the name should stay as it is. SpongeBob wasn't listening and continued to come up with new name ideas. After several ideas, SpongeBob and Pearl landed on the Kuddly Krab. They were happy, but Squidward was pissed. An adult couple were upset the Krusty Krab was now getting with the times and thought Squidward was a girl because of his uniform. Squidward was outraged and quit and got a ticket on his crotch. It didn't take long for the Kuddly Krab to become popular with teenagers.
You know, now that I think about it, since there's a lot of pink and bright colors inside the Kuddly Krab, is it really for teenagers or is it for girls no matter how old they are? Because there are way more girls in the Kuddly Krab than there are guys.
SpongeBob thought that all these new teenager customers was a great thing for the restaurant and thought Pearl's ideas were doing well. SpongeBob went back to work, and Pearl gave him an order for 2 salads. SpongeBob wasn't sure of what salads were, but he knew he had to stay hip or he'd end up like Squidward.
Well, Squidward quit, so I'm sure SpongeBob won't share the same fate.
SpongeBob made 2 Krabby Patties, and Pearl told him to strip them down till only the lettuce and tomato were left. SpongeBob did so, but he was not happy at all, and served the salads to the ladies. SpongeBob returned to the kitchen and saw that the grill was gone. Pearl showed SpongeBob that she came up with a new menu that consisted only of salad and tea.
I think teenagers ate more than just salad and tea.
Pearl took away SpongeBob's spatula and had him wear an embarrassing costume, which resulted in a guy saying he's going to the Big Doofus convention.
Doesn't that mean the guy was calling himself a doofus, therefore insulting himself?
SpongeBob finally decided to tell Mr. Krabs what he thought. He went into Mr. Krabs' office, and Mr. Krabs was talking about how much everything in his new office cost. SpongeBob said that Pearl was ruining the Krusty Krab, and Mr. Krabs went on and on about the $20 sea unicorn wall hangers, $35 heart lights, and a sea fern on each table.
But how much does the sea fern cost?
Mr. Krabs agreed with SpongeBob, but he was worried about firing Pearl because he didn't want to break her heart. SpongeBob wanted to help, so Mr. Krabs decided to have SpongeBob fire Pearl instead. SpongeBob takes Pearl into the kitchen, but before he even says anything, Pearl starts crying. She then admits that she's been trying to get fired since the start because the job was cutting majorly into her social life.
Welcome to reality, Pearl.
SpongeBob then decides to act as if he was firing her in front of Mr. Krabs, and Pearl was delighted to hear this. Later on, they went outside Mr. Krabs' office so he would hear them. Mr. Krabs couldn't bear to listen to it, but then he saw himself in the mirror and his empty safe. SpongeBob then fired Pearl, and he passed out. Pearl thanked him and kissed him.
Damn. And to think the show staff said that SpongeBob has no sexual orientation.
Pearl happily left, and SpongeBob provided Mr. Krabs with the smell of a $20 bill. Mr. Krabs was upset, but soon cheered up when SpongeBob told him that Pearl took it just fine. He then wonders how he'll get his money back for all the decorations. SpongeBob takes them home, only at the cost of 1 year's salary, which makes Gary sad, and the episode ends. So that was Bossy Boots, and in my opinion, it's a good episode. It has some great scenes, like when SpongeBob kept bringing up some kind of new spatulas, and everybody was getting wazzed off, the new name SpongeBob kept coming up with for the new Krusty Krab, and Squidward ripping off his uniform, and the officer putting a ticket on his I also think it's neat that both this and its sister episode, Something Smells, both involve a scene where a cop comes out of nowhere just to put a ticket on something and walk away immediately. I always liked when a pair of episodes that are paired up together have something like this in common, other than SpongeBob himself, of course. Now, I want to go over some things that I noticed on my latest rewatch that I found odd. In this episode, SpongeBob had never heard of a salad before, despite there being a salad bar in the Krusty Krab in episode 20, Culture Shock. Sure, he wasn't shown working at the salad bar itself in the episode, but it's still strange that he didn't know about salads in this episode. The other major thing I wanted to wonder is why Pearl was working at the Krusty Krab even though she was trying to get fired so badly. Now yes, I do think it's very likely that Mr. Krabs wanted Pearl to work at the Krusty Krab during the summer, but there was never a specific reason that was verbally stated as to why she was working at the Krusty Krab in the first place, so I kinda wonder why this was the case. Although, if I'm being 100% honest, I always sorta thought that Pearl almost did want to work at the Krusty Krab a little bit when I was a kid, but on day one she realized how much work it actually would be and just wanted to quit. Or maybe she wanted to work there, but right before, she started spending a lot more time with her friends and wanted to get fired as soon as she was hired. And I must reiterate, yes, I know it's possible Mr. Krabs wanted her to work for him, but she could have been too afraid to say no and just wanted to be fired. This next point isn't a major criticism, but more so something I just wondered. Even though Pearl did intend on making the Krusty Krab into a teenage hangout place, I almost got the impression that it was for people who were slightly younger than teenagers, mostly because the Kuddly Krab is very pink and has things like stuffed animals and sea unicorn wall hangers. Sure, boys can have things like stuffed animals, hell, I had some as a kid, but to me, it didn't look like some kind of regular teenage club you'd see in TV shows or movies, so I always got the impression that it was more for people like preteens or slightly younger kids than just teenagers. But hey, what do I know? I grew out of those teenage years a long time ago, so don't listen to me.
Please don't. I'm rarely right about anything.
Also, when Gary meowed sadly at the end, I always felt bad for him. He did look like he was trapped in the toys because you can't really see his shell, and I thought that too from time to time. But he's more likely sad because of how SpongeBob traded a 1 year salary for all the toys. It's right at the end too, so that makes it all the more complicated. Even with all that in mind, I do still think this is a good episode. I always found SpongeBob hugging that pole to be pretty humorous, and I also love Squidward's reaction after SpongeBob expresses that he loves the new uniform.
Fish paste.
It's so slow and monotone, it just made me laugh a lot. Other than that, I don't think I have a whole lot more to say. I don't think there's much more I really can talk about with this episode. It's not a bad episode by any means, but I don't really think there's much more to it. Even back then, I didn't see as many people talk about this episode compared to its sister episode, but luckily, I don't see a lot of people shrugging this episode off in comparison to a few other episode pairs where one episode is considered better or more memorable than its sister episode. I'm starting to find continuing on a little difficult, so I think I'll wrap things up.
Bossy Boots is a good episode. It may be considered weaker than some other episodes this season, but that's not a bad thing since season 2 still has a lot of great episodes. It's still funny and memorable, so it can't really be considered bad in my opinion. But no matter what we all may think about this episode, I think the main takeaway from this episode is that getting with the times will get us as human beings absolutely nowhere in life.